Hello everyone, welcome back to another Adobe Photoshop CC 2018 tutorial. In this one, I'm going to show you how to do composites and how to get rid of the lines and the green and stuff like that that goes around composite pictures where you're putting one picture on top of another. You know, like green screens and when you got babies in space and stuff like that. If you don't know what I mean, just watch, follow along with me and I'll show you how to do this. The first step here is I've created a new just go to File, New. If you're working along with me, File, New. And I just created a blank 1920 by 1080 because that's the YouTube thumbnail size that I use. There we go. So just follow along with me. The second step is we want to just get rid of these guys. I'm just going to clear them off because I don't want to work with them right now. The next step here, I'm going to go to my desktop and I'm going to drag and drop on a picture. And the first picture is going to be the Milky Way. So I just drag and drop that on there and you're going to see that this is here, the Milky Way, or whatever the hell it is, and bang, I'm going to hit OK. It's not that big, so I'm going to make it a little bigger just for this image, or just for this tutorial. So we'll do something like that, and boom, OK. So we've now got a background of the Milky Way. The next step is I'm going to take that picture or that portrait of this girl here, and these are all stuff that I just found online. These are free pictures you can just pick and choose. So use whatever you want in this tutorial. It's more about the technique as opposed to the final look here. So I'm going to drag and drop that on there just like I did, and I'm going to hit OK. And now I've got this girl here. I'm going to make her portrait a bit bigger too. And there we go. As long as it fills up the screen, let's center it, something like that. What do you think? Yeah, there we go. Bang. I'm going to hit Enter. Now, what I want is her with the space in the background, and I want to get rid of all the gray, and I just want to have her and her image, including her cool-looking hair here, look like she's in outer space. Very, very difficult to do, but inside of Photoshop CC 2018, there are three things you can do to make it look very, very professional. The first one is I'm going to make sure that I'm clicked on the top image, which is the portrait image. I'm going to go up to Select, and this is new to CC 2018. Just came out in January, I believe. January 22nd. And there's something called Subject. Under Select, Select Subject. That's a lot of S's. Now watch. It'll take a few seconds for it to do that. But while it's thinking, boom, we have the subject selected. Now you are going to notice it is not exactly perfect, but it's pretty good, and it'll do for this tutorial. I will show you other techniques to get a little bit more of the wispy hair outside, but this is good for now. So we've gone ahead and done that, and then the next step here, guys, is to go and click this button here. Add layer mask. There we go. Add layer mask, and now boom. We got rid of most of the gray, and she's in outer space. But obviously, this still looks very, very rough and amateurish because we've got all this gray and pieces missing and stuff like that. So that's where we're going to come in, and we're going to start doing some more work. The second step, or the next step, pardon me, is you want to go up to Select, and you're probably familiar with this. You want to go now down to the Select and Mask. Let's go ahead and do that, and then you're going to get this opening up. Now, before I go any further, please make a note that I have this on layers for my view. It defaults to onion skin, but onion skin doesn't really work very well for this type of stuff. So I've got it selected to on layers. The next step is you want to use edge detection. This has been around for a while, and it's something you guys are probably familiar with. So I'll just crank it all the way up to 195 so you can see. Obviously, we went way too far, but I just want you to see what it looks like. So I'm going to go with something like, what do you think? Something like 5 pixels. There we go. Something like that. Looking good, looking good. The next step is you want to drop down global refinements. We'll take a look at this. I don't think we need to do anything there. So we'll skip that one. And now we're going to go and start painting. So over here on the left side, you'll see Refine Edge Brush Tool. Now, we can just go ahead and you can increase or decrease the size of the brush, so to speak, using the left and right bracket key. I'm going to increase it to about this size. Yeah, let's go with that. And now I'm just going to start brushing along the edges of the hair. And you guys have probably gone through this, and you know exactly what's going on here. So this is nothing new to you. Let's see if I can get rid of that. Yes, I can. Good, because that was messy. And now I'm going to go ahead and brush these parts of the hair over here. Yeah, looking good, but still, we've got some gray in there, and still has like a bit of an amateurish look, right? So the third and the final step, well, let's hit OK and show you what it looks like now. So, OK, we've got her in there. I just locked and on and offed it. But again, we've got some color. We've got some gray here that just doesn't look natural. Now comes the final step. You want to make sure you clicked on the first layer. We're going to go back in. We're going to go select and mask again. So just do it again. This time, you want to click decontaminate colors. Now watch this. Bang! Just pressing that button, we've got some awesome, and I mean awesome, effect going on here where we've pretty much hit the nail on the head. Just like that. When I click that and I go through it, oh wow, oops, I shouldn't have done that, but there you go. Guys, this is almost picture perfect. It's got a few things, you know, there was some wispy hair in the original. If I turn that off and then, I'm not going to go through all that mess. There's a little bit of hair out here that was wispy that we didn't quite get with the subject when we clicked on select subject, but we got a lot of it, guys, and this, you know, unless you really know what the hell her hair looks like, it looks very professional. So that's how you do it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'll be back more with some more stuff shortly. Thanks for watching.